Hallelujah, we're back. Guys, this isn't going to be a super long video. I have some work to attend to. But let us be about our Father's business. We must work the works of He who's called us out of darkness into His marvelous light now while it is day. And continue on in this glorious gospel and the grace of God that is upon our lives, this supernatural favor of God, Charisse, loving kindness of God the Father. We behold His beauty at the beauty of the revelation of the understanding of the cross of Jesus Christ. We are blessed coming in and we are blessed going out. The Spirit of the Lord God is upon us because He has anointed us. He has appointed us to preach the gospel to every living creature, to proclaim the good news of Jesus Christ, that Jesus Christ has come into the world to save sinners. He came not to call the righteous, but sinners to repentance. We come through the narrow way, for the broad way leads to destruction. We come through that narrow way, which leads to life everlasting. And guys, I apologize for not being on here for a little while, but we're back in action because no weapon formed against us shall prosper. And sometimes there are seasons where God has us ministering in different forms, in different ways to different people. So it's important to know the times, and it's important to know, it's important to know the seasons. It's important to know the times and to discern the seasons and to discern the times appointed of the Father. And there is great joy coming upon you in the name of Jesus Christ. There is great peace coming upon you in the name of Jesus Christ. There is great strength coming upon you in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. I am with you. I am for you, my brothers. I am with you. I am for you, my brothers and sisters in Christ. I rejoice when you rejoice. I weep when you weep. And this is the family of God. We rejoice with each other on each other's journeys. We encourage one another on one another's journeys rather than rip everybody apart and tear everybody down and be plagued with the spirit of envy or jealousy or hatred even towards one another. But let us come together and gather together in peace, in love, in harmony, in unity within the community, even more as we see the day of the Lord approaching. And let us just sever the spirit of division which is upon the land among the people of God and come together for this move of God, which is mighty manifestation of the presence and spirit of God on the earth one last time. Preach the gospel to every living creature. Those who believe and are baptized shall be saved, and those who believe not shall be condemned. But we are believers in Christ. Amen? And some people on here may not be. But it's a blessed life to believe in the one and only Son of God who died and gave Himself as a ransom for all mankind, that we can come boldly before the throne room of grace and receive mercy, forgiveness, and strength and empowerment and grace in the time of need. So hallelujah for that. We cannot earn it. We do not deserve it. Freely we have been given. Freely we have received, so freely we pour out what we've been given. We have not been given just to hoard the blessings of God. So some people are believing God for a new car. Some people are believing God for a new house. Some people are believing God for a full wallet. But we are blessed to be a blessing. Money is only a tool for the kingdom of God. An apartment is only a tool and an asset for the kingdom of God. A car is only a tool. It's only an asset for the kingdom of God. And I believe that in ministry, some people have lost sight, have literally lost their mind about what this thing is really about. Jesus said, you want to follow me? You can follow me. Come right ahead. But The Son of Man has nowhere to lay his head tonight. Do you still want to follow? Do we still want to follow? Even if we lost it all, will we still follow? I once was lost, but now I'm found by the amazing grace of Jesus Christ. Do we still want to follow when it looks like everything's falling apart around us? Do we still want to follow when we are perplexed and there's distress at every angle? Do we still want to follow when we didn't get our way? Do we still want to follow sugar-coated, candy-coated preaching and teaching? No, but the grace of God, the gospel of grace message is empowerment to give strength in those times of need, because Jesus knew we were going to need it. Jesus knows we never could earn this. We never could deserve this. But he humbled himself, being fully God and fully man. He humbled himself, came down from heaven to earth, and was the ultimate sacrifice of all time for all mankind. And we either receive it and believe it, or we don't. We're either under the blessing or we're under the curse. We're either filled with everlasting life from the inside out, or the ministry of condemnation, or a reconciliation. There's either sheeps or goats, and the great falling away has already started. And it's time to make up our minds, for there are multitudes in the valley of decision. And we all have a decision to make today about different areas of our life, different areas of our lives where the enemy's attempting to make our faith waver, different decisions about which way we should go. Should we go to the right? Should we go to the left? The Lord has heard our prayers, and the Lord has answered. The Lord has heard your prayers, and the Lord is answering each and every prayer. And the answer is already established. And like Daniel waited 21 days to see the answer come, becoming manifest to him. The answer is in the spirit realm, and sometimes we are going through a test of patience. We are going through a test of endurance as we are waiting on the answer, and we're looking around to the left, and we're looking around to the right, and we're looking up, and we're looking down. And that's just what the enemy wants when the storm hits. Those people who were on the boat with Jesus Christ were looking at the sea and the waves roaring and raging, and the present circumstance in the physical, in the natural, in their reality. But the actual reality is in the spirit, on earth as it is in heaven. So although it may look like the waves are crashing into your life, and the boat is beginning to rock, and the boat is beginning to get shaken up, we don't have to get shaken up from the inside out, but we can be at a peace even when there's a storm on the outside, because Jesus was at so much peace that he was sleeping during the storm. And we can have that peace on the inside, living on the inside of us as that storm is occurring on the outside. The outside forces don't have to affect the inside of us when we are filled with the Holy Spirit of truth, when we are filled with the Holy Spirit of power, when we are filled with the Holy Spirit that brings a fire of God from the inside out. This is just burning with passion, with the love of Christ. It's the love of Christ that compels us to move forward, even against all odds, even against all opposition, even against the enemy's plots, the enemy's schemes. No weapon formed against us can prosper or shall prosper. We either believe it and receive it, or we don't. We're either on the right or we're on the left. We're either sheeps or we're goats. We're either saved or we're not saved. We're either believers and children of God or we're not. It's going to come to a point where everybody's going to have to make a decision, and we are living in the last days. There is a great falling away. Lukewarm is not an option. But let us keep our candlesticks lit with the fire of God. Let us have oil in our lamps to be ready for the coming of the Messiah, who's coming back again. And every eye shall see him as he comes back in the clouds with power and great glory, and he shall gather his elect from the four corners of the earth. Hallelujah. He is worthy. It is well with our soul, and that brings a peace from the inside out. We put our hand to the plow and we look forward. We don't look back. We are not such as those who look behind us. Many are looking back at things of the past, at the circumstances, at the failures, at the mishaps, at the word curses that people have spoken into our lives that we have come into agreement with, that are lies about our identity of who we really are in Christ. Do we know who we are in Him, in Christ? Without Him, it's nothing. It's meaningless. It's done in vain. Without Christ, all that we labor to do is nothing. Everything is Christ. In Christ, in Him we move, in Him we breathe, in Him we have our being. And I woke up a couple days ago, and this is what I heard in my heart. In Christ, you will live. And that sounds so simple, right? Like, okay, I'm thinking I've read the scriptures before. In Christ, I will live. You know, there could be certain scriptures that we've read over and over and over and over, but to meditate upon the scripture line upon line and precept upon precept, allowing scripture to interpret itself by the Holy Spirit of truth, which will lead us and guide us into all truth, are two different things. We will know the truth, and the truth shall make or set us free. Amen. So in Christ, you will live. And it just sounded like such a simple statement, but such a profound one at the same time. Not in Christ, you will not live. To live is Christ. To die is gain. And we move on to glory, to streets of gold, to life everlasting. But while we are here, we are about our Father's business. There's a mission, there's a purpose, there's a destiny that's being unfolded, that's being accomplished in us and through our lives as we are witnesses, as we are a living testimony that Jesus Christ is real, is the Son of God. And He died for you, and He died for me, and He died for all of humanity. And if the rest of humanity didn't even exist besides you, He died for you alone. He leaves the 99 to go after the one that went astray. So I'm speaking to those who may have went astray. I'm speaking to those who may not even know the Lord at all. I'm speaking to those who may feel like they're on the fence about their eternity. I'm speaking to those who may feel convicted that it's a possibility they're lukewarm today. And I speak to the soul, life in Christ Jesus, we will live. So He fills us with the Spirit. And that Spirit is a life-giving Spirit with resurrection power. Some resurrected unto the second death, which is the lake of fire. Others resurrected unto life everlasting. Eternal life lies within Christ Jesus and in Him alone. There is no other name given among men whereby we must be saved. And this is not the message that the entire world is carrying. And because of this message, there is division. But even amongst the division in the world, it doesn't mean that there has to be division in the body of Christ. We can come into the agreement of unity. We can come into the agreement of harmony. We can come into the agreement of love. And I've done a lot of debating in my time in the past couple of years. I've went back and forth a lot about scriptures. But in all that debating and all that going back and forth, I came to the understanding and revelation that it all comes back to the core of the love of God. And let's just get back to the basics with this thing. It's all about the love of God. So let's just show people the love of God today. Let's just get off of our high horse and our know-it-all, and this is right and that's wrong, and you're right and she's wrong, and you can't do this and you shouldn't say that, and the scripture means it this way and you said it that way. But let's just allow scripture to interpret the scripture and to each other personally, in the personal relationship with Jesus Christ. You know, to some he's given apostles, to others he's given pastors, to others he's given prophets, to some he's given evangelists, to some he's given preachers, to some he's given teachers for the edifying of the saints, for the equipping of the saints, for the work of the ministry. And let's just move in the particular office that we are called to move in by the Spirit's anointing that we've been ordained from heaven by Jesus Christ to move in whatever office he's called you to. I encourage you today to move in the calling and to let no man restrain you from your calling, and to let no demon, no devil stop you or halt you in moving in your calling in Christ Jesus. So I would just like to pray. I really would love to stay on here for a while, but there's work I must attend to, maybe later, but definitely we're back in action here. So there's different seasons, and don't think that I forgot about you guys. There's different seasons where we are to minister in different ways. So we're back in action right here and right now live. So whatever Holy Spirit says, we answer yes and amen on the spot, spontaneously, just like that. So anybody that feels led to pray along with me, feel free. And I really hope you guys are having a blessed day. Okay. All right. So we just thank you, Heavenly Father, for your anointing that destroys every yoke right now. We come against all demonic patterns and mindsets and cycles. By the blood of Jesus, we break transgression and iniquity, because you have broken it by the power of the cross. Thank you, Lord, that you took our sickness, that we may be healed, that we may become whole. We just thank you for the cross of Jesus Christ right now. And for those who don't know you, feel free to just pray. Just say, Lord, I don't know you, but I want to know you. I confess I'm a sinner. I confess I'm in need of a Savior. I believe that you died, that you were crucified, that you were buried, that you resurrected and rose on the third day. Jesus, I make you my Lord. Jesus, I make you my Savior. I open my heart to you, and I ask that you would forgive me and come into my heart, fill me with the Holy Spirit, with power, with fire, with a passion for a stronger relationship with you and a hunger for your word. Your grace is sufficient, and I break every generational curse off my family bloodline from here on out by the power of the blood of Jesus Christ. Holy boldness, come forth. Demonic restrictions, be broken now in Jesus' name. I give you praise, I give you honor, I give you glory. Use me for a testimony. Save my loved ones, my friends, and my family. Reveal your truth in my life and to those around me. Use me completely for your glory. I surrender and I yield my vessel unto you. Lord God, have your way in my life. Your word says you will never leave me nor forsake me. I come against every enemy lie, and I allow the truth to set me free right now. In Jesus Christ's holy, precious name I pray. We pray. Amen and amen. There's more to come, and if the Spirit leads, we'll be back later. If not, then some other time in the near future. So I will continue praying for all of you guys, and I hope that all of you guys would please continue praying for me and our families, and keep the joy of the Lord going strong. Amen. Amen.